Hello, everyone. In today's session, we're diving into how to create a drop-down menu for your navbar. And we're doing it the smart way, using Droip's MegaMenu. Stick around till the end, because we'll be walking you through everything you need to know to get it working smoothly. Let's get into it. All right, so we're starting with a completely blank editor. Let's add a section to give it some life. We'll head over to the Insert panel. You'll see options like Sections, Pages, and Wireframes. For now, let's grab something from the Wireframe category. There are quite a few ready-made layouts here, but let's go with a Hero section to keep things simple. This one looks good. Let's drag it in. And just like that, our blank canvas isn't so blank anymore. Already looks much better. Now, let's head back to our main task, building that navigation dropdown. We'll jump back into the Insert panel, since that's where all our design goodies live. This time, we'll open up the Elements panel, and let's go ahead and make it sticky, just to keep things easy while we work. Now, scroll all the way down to the bottom of the Elements list, and you'll find the Advanced tab. Right at the top of that tab, you'll see the Navigation element. Let's drag and drop it above our Hero section, and boom, we've got a navbar. Now, you might be wondering, why aren't we just pulling the drop-down element directly from here? Great question. Well, Droip's MegaMenu is purpose-built within the navigation element itself. That means everything is already set up for you, making the whole process faster and smoother. And don't worry, we're about to see exactly how that works. All right, now that we've got our navigation element on the canvas, let's take a quick look inside the Layers panel to see how it's structured. So, you'll notice there are two main frames, or let's say two div blocks. One of them contains all the nav menu items, and the other holds buttons and action elements, like signups or CTAs. Let's go ahead and add a shape element to represent our logo for now. We'll wrap it inside a div block, and let's name that something like... brand name. Yeah, that works. Now, we'll paste in our SVG code right there. Hit update, and boom, the logo's in place. Of course, you can use a text element or an image element instead of a shape, depending on how you want your logo to appear. Totally up to you. Oh, and just a quick tip, you can easily resize your shapes or images by simply dragging the edges. Super intuitive, so feel free to adjust it however it fits your design best. But for now, let's keep it just the way it is and move on. Now, if we take a look at the layout, we've got our logo on the left and the nav menus on the right. Let's scale the editor view back to default. Yeah, that's much better for designing. Now here's the cool part. The navigation element already comes with a flex structure in place. If you check the settings, you'll see that the justify content is set to space between. That's why the items are pushed to the far left and right with space between them, giving a clean, balanced layout right out of the box. This is one of the big advantages of using Droip's pre-built navigation. It saves you from setting up all those layout properties from scratch. Let's make a couple of quick adjustments. We'll add some horizontal padding to the navigation so it doesn't stick to the edges, and let's set the height of the navbar to 60 pixels for a more compact look. And there we have it. With just a couple of simple tweaks, we've got ourselves a fully designed navbar, looking clean and ready to go. All right, now comes the exciting part, the MegaMenu. When you select the navigation element, you'll notice there are three options available. The last one is the standard settings panel you'll see on most elements, but the first two? Those are navigation specific, designed to help you control nav items and their behavior. For today, we're sticking with the Nav Items tab. That's where we'll start setting up our MegaMenu. When you click on the Nav Items tab, you'll notice it mirrors the same menu structure you see in the Layers panel, but with a lot more control packed in. Each item comes with a three-dot menu where you can set individual URLs, rename or delete items, and any changes you make here will automatically sync with the Layers panel, keeping everything up to date effortlessly. But it doesn't stop there. You can also reorder the nav items by simply dragging them around and even nest them to blueprint your multi-level menus, all right from this panel. Once you're clear on how you want to organize your submenus, it's time to structure them using the MegaMenu. At the bottom of the Nav Items panel, you'll see an Add Item option. Click on that and you'll get a variety of options to link different content to your web page. At the very end of this list, you'll find the MegaMenu option. Let's give that a click. There it is, added at the end of our nav items. we'll leave it there for now. The Mega Menu comes with several built-in layers, so you don't need to build the drop-down structure and behavior from the ground up. Everything is ready to go. The key one for us is the menu wrapper. This is where we'll place our submenu items. Let's add a link block as an example. After saving, hit preview. Now, when you hover over the Mega Menu, you'll see the submenu link appear. Pretty neat, but you'll notice the submenu is just simple, and that's something we'll need to fix.
But when we jump back to the editor, you might notice the submenu isn't visible yet, but we need to design it and position it properly. And this is where things get really interesting. So, select the navigation element, then go to Nav Items. Click the three-dot menu on the Mega Menu item, and you'll find the Show Menu option. Click that, and voila! The hidden submenu appears right in your editor, ready for us to style and customize. With that done, we can now edit, design, and position the submenu however we want. Now, instead of using the link block, let's drag in a symbol of the submenu we already created. We're skipping the entire submenu design phase here because right now, our full focus is on the Mega Menu and its details. Don't worry though, we'll cover designing the submenu in detail at the end of this video. As you can see, it's not quite positioned correctly yet. Let's try adding some margins to the menu wrapper. All right, before we jump in, let's first adjust our view so we can see the entire page layout and know exactly where we're editing. Now, let's select the Nav Items block from our Mega Menu. This block is set to absolute positioning, which means it's designed to neatly stack on top of other elements. Super handy for dropdowns. Let's go ahead and set the right position to 0% to align it properly. Next, we'll select the menu wrapper and give it a bit of spacing with some margins. Let's try 100 pixels on the right and maybe 20 pixels on the top. And yep, looks like it's sitting in just the right spot now. Now hit save and preview. When you hover over the Mega Menu, our submenu list appears perfectly, and our drop-down menu is ready. Did you notice something cool? We didn't have to manually set up how the drop-down behaves, like where it appears, how it overlaps content, or any of those tricky technical details. That's the beauty of using the Mega Menu. It's a huge time saver, especially if you're a beginner or a designer who doesn't want to get into coding. You get a fully functional drop-down experience without needing to build it from scratch. Now, if we had taken a standard drop-down element from the Elements panel instead, we'd have to handle everything ourselves, from configuring the behavior to managing absolute positioning, which can get messy. But with the Mega Menu, all of that is already baked into the layout, so you can focus on designing instead of debugging. Of course, if we don't add a down arrow, no one will realize it's a drop-down. So, back in the editor, inside the Mega Menu, let's grab an icon element. To keep things neat and organized, let's wrap the text and icon together inside a div block. Trust me, wrapping elements in divs makes editing and designing way smoother and cleaner. Now, selecting the icon. Wow, there's a huge collection here. Let's go to Material Icon, scroll down a bit. Or, better yet, just search for arrows. Perfect. This down arrow looks just right. Oops, the size is a bit off. Lock the height and width and set both to about 16 pixels. Yeah, that looks much better. Next, the text and icon are vertically misaligned. To fix that, select the div block we just made, set its layout to flex, and align it center-center. See? Told you wrapping elements in div blocks helps keep things smooth and easy. Let's preview our changes. Hover over the menu, and there you go. The submenu appears with a nice arrow indicator. We could also take it a step further and change the cursor behavior to make the interaction feel more intuitive. So let's select the Mega Menu in the editor, then head over to the Effects panel. Scroll down a bit, and you'll see the option to customize the cursor. Let's go with the pointer. That's a classic choice for clickable elements. Now hit preview, and there it is. Maybe we want a slight arrow indicator outside the submenu as well. To make this work, we first made sure that the div inside the menu wrapper has 100% width. That gives us the full boundary to work within. Next, let's add a new icon element right into that div.
Now let's pick a different icon, preferably an upward arrow since that fits the drop-down behavior.
This one looks better. Let's zoom in a little for a clearer view. Much better. Now to position the arrow correctly, we'll set the div's layout to flex and choose row reverse for the direction. See how the arrow jumps from left to right? That's exactly what we want. We're aiming to place the arrow over here, so let's try adding some right padding. Looking better already. And maybe a little negative bottom margin to fine-tune the placement. Nice. Lastly, let's change the icon color. Head over to the typography panel and set the color there. And that's it. Let's do a quick preview to see how it all looks in action.
And just like that, we've added clear, stylish drop-down indicators. It saves you tons of time on layout setup. Plus, you get built-in visibility controls, interactions, and much more. However, if you're not totally happy with the default hover behavior, no worries. You can easily tweak it using the interaction panel. By default, our mega menu just drops down instantly and disappears as soon as you hover out. But what if you want the drop-down to have a subtle transition effect, like a smooth drop? Here's how. First, select the mega menu, then go to the interaction panel and set the trigger type to mouse hover. We selected the trigger for mega menu because our action will take place when we hover over the mega menu element here. For the hover in action, we want the submenu to drop, so the target will be the nav items. Since the submenu becomes visible on hover, we'll use the opacity attribute and set it to 1. For the transition, set the duration to 300 milliseconds with an ease out. Next, for a nice touch, let's make the drop-down arrow icon rotate when the menu drops. Set the icon as the next target and choose the rotate attribute on the Z-axis to 180 degrees for that upside-down effect. Give it a transition duration of about 200 milliseconds. Now, duplicate these settings for hover out, but reverse the values. Set opacity to 0, transition ease in, and rotate the icon back to 0 degrees on the Z-axis. And that's it. Now preview your work and enjoy this beautifully seamless animated drop-down menu. And for those of you curious about how the submenu was designed, let's take a quick look by inspecting the symbol we used earlier. So it's built on a simple structure. We have a parent div and inside that several link blocks. The parent div uses a grid layout with some overall padding applied and likely a few tweaks to the grid gap values for spacing. The max height and width are set to fit content, keeping it neat and responsive. All the child text elements use the Roboto font, there's a basic background color, and a soft border radius all around. Now, if we look at the link blocks, they're set up with a flex structure, which allows the icon and text to sit side by side with a horizontal gap between them, nice and clean. Each icon shape has a defined size, and there's also a slight spacing between the menu title and its description, giving it some breathing room. And that's pretty much it. A simple, well-structured submenu that does the job beautifully. Just make sure to link the menu items to their proper destination URLs, and we're all good to go.
Thanks for watching, and drop your comment on what tutorials you need for further guidance. And up next, we are coming with more exciting videos. Till then, stay tuned.